Tracy, there hadn't been an officer-involved shooting in Kennebunk in decades. That changed last night when police responded to a domestic disturbance call that turned deadly.
It's a quiet condominium neighborhood in a quiet coastal town. Evidence of that, the fact that Alan Giancola didn't even know police were at the condo unit that shares a wall with his, or that something serious had happened.
At 9 o'clock, I did hear a loud bang, and I thought it was my wife doing something in the kitchen, but she wasn't. And now I'm putting two and two together, and that obviously must have been the shot by the officer.
That officer was Joshua Morneau, who's been on the force since 2005. Kennebunk police say Morneau and Sergeant Juliet Gilman were dispatched to the condo for a domestic disturbance call. When they got there, 39-year-old Catherine Paulson and her mother were at home, and according to police, Paulson confronted Officer Morneau with deadly force. He shot and killed her.
These situations, they can get out of hand. We routinely go to these situations and we try to mediate them as best we can. And we may have to make split second decisions, which is what we're trained to do. And unfortunately, that's what needed to be made last night.
It's also an indication of how quickly situations can escalate, authorities say. The original call was not enough for police to use lights and sirens to get there.
We were just told it was, some kind of domestic disturbance, but it didn't elicit at that particular point a stepped-up response.
Police say they have responded to this home several times before for medical emergencies, but never for a criminal complaint. Neighbors also say nothing out of the ordinary has happened at the condo since Paulson and her mother moved in a couple years ago. But this, they say, certainly is unusual.
And they were quiet people, never creating any problems, no issues. They kept to themselves, more or less.
Well, I just feel very sad for everyone concerned. It's sad for the police and for the girl that died. I think it's just a circumstance that happened that probably never will happen again, You never know.
An autopsy was conducted on Paulson's body today, but the medical examiner is not releasing the results, and the attorney general's office will not elaborate on the situation or say what kind of weapon, if any, Paulson had. Live in the newsroom, Keith Baldy, News 8.